So today I'm here with, do you want to say your name? This is Isla, and she just got home from kindergarten, and you want to make a video together? All right. We're going to show you how to make checkboxes in Excel. They're pretty new, so you might not have seen them before. Today is the day. Isla, should we tell them that they're watching Dataviz On The Go? We make YouTube videos for them to help them with their job and help them save time. Yeah. So let me show you how you make these because they're pretty easy. So what you're going to do is you click on the empty cell where you want to add them. And then you go to insert and they're there. They're right there. So you click on the checkbox box. It adds an empty one and you just drag them down and then you fill them in. Look, when you click on the square, do you know what happens? You get a little check mark like that. What I used to do is you would click on the cell, you go to insert, you go to icons. Do you see the little duck, Isla, right there? And then you'd have to scroll through the whole menu if it loads, right? And do you see all these pictures in here? And you could pick one like this that's kind of similar, right? That one has a circle and you could add it and you could, this is a newish feature too, you could place it in the cell, which is kind of nice, but then you can't click on it. You know, you get the same end result, but you don't have the process, the clickable process in it. So that's all right. That's kind of the old way. What I used to do is, Isla, do you know what letter this is? Do you recognize that one? It makes the G sound. That's a G. I used to do like this. And then do you know that one? That's a C. Yeah, we were looking, that makes a K sound, right? Like cat. We were looking at that in your Bob books last night. Okay, what I used to do is I would do G's and C's, G for good, C for crappy. We probably shouldn't say that word out loud though. And then you change them to Webdings, if I can type with one hand, Webdings, and you sort of get the same appearance, right? Do you see how that's not quite a checkbox? It's like a filled in square and an empty square. So it's not quite as cute. Yeah, it doesn't have a check. That's why I like these. They look like checks. I also like them because, look, you can delete them if you change your mind. You just hit the delete key on your keyboard. And you can change the size. You can make them like hugely huge. Whoa, too big. Probably we just want them the same size as the font, though. You can change the color. What color should we pick? Like purple? Green. Green. We can make them green. And we can also count them up. How many checks are filled in right here? Two. Yeah, exactly. And let's say you had a really long list and you didn't want to count them all because it would just take forever. You could do this formula. You could do count if, and you could say, I'm going to count this list and I'm going to count the trues. True means filled in. False means not filled in. Right. And then you get two to save yourself a little bit of time. Right. And make sure you don't make typos. I also really like these because they have not just regular color, but conditional color. Conditional color means, you know, you could make them all black, you could make them all green, you could make them all red, but let me show you, let me copy and paste these, right? I'm going to make them all red, right? They're all just red font. And then I'm going to make it so that when the check is checked, they're green, right? Stoplight, red, green. Do you know when we're driving and we see the stoplight on the street and it's like red means
stop.
Red means stop. Yeah, you're right. So red means like, whoa, caution, bad. Everybody kind of understands that in the data world too. Let's see, conditional formatting here. Let's go to new rule and let's say which one do we want? Format cells that contain. And we want it to be a specific text. And if it is a true, then we will set that one to. Is it going to load? Is it going to load? Let's try it again. Format. We want the font color to be green. Okay, so we made it all red, except if it's checked, it's green. And then click OK a couple times, and you get the stoplight coding, which is possible, but I think it looks really ugly. I don't know. I think that's like too colorful almost. What do you think? What I also,
Chris,
It is Christmas colored, you're right. You could also do, you could make it all gray and that everything's checked in then is green. I like this one better. It's not quite so busy. What do you think with the gray? First. You like the first one better. You like a lot of colors, right? Mommy more likes plain stuff, I guess. We could focus on the checks. We could also focus on the boxes, which we would do that with. I can't remember. It doesn't matter. It would be the opposite of what we just did in conditional formatting. All right. And then another reason I like checkboxes like this is that they are colorblind friendly and they are grayscale friendly. Even technically this one with reds and greens is colorblind friendly. Isla, do you know what colorblind means? Have you heard of that before? No, I bet some kids in your class might be colorblind. It's pretty common. It's like 1 in 12 boys, they don't see red and green. Did you know that? They see it as yellow. I'm going to show you what it looks like if you were colorblind. I'm going to take a little picture of the screen and we'll put it here.
So the people wouldn't hear my red and
green. No, they wouldn't see red and green. I'm going to show you what it would look like if first maybe some of the boys in your class, since it's pretty common. Let's go to color-blindness.com. We clicked on color tools, CVD simulator. And we're going to choose that screenshot that I just put on the desktop. Here it is, colorblind test. And this is what it looks like for me and you, right? We can see like the Christmas colors right here. But if somebody had red-green colorblindness, they wouldn't see red and green. They would see a bunch of yellows. But even though this looks like a bunch of yellows, it's okay. They can still see the checks versus the empty. So we're good. They can see like the colored in part, right? Which is nice. Or if you printed this out, does your teacher has printouts and worksheets at school, right? Your teacher to save ink might print in grayscale sometimes, and this is what it would look like in grayscale. So it's super colorblind friendly and grayscale friendly. So it gets an approval. All right, the only downside to checkboxes is they do not transfer well to Word or PowerPoint. You want to see what happens if you try to put them into this thing called Word, Isla? It's not good. It's not good. They are not going to show up as well. They're going to look like much. They're going to look like funny little like machine rectangles. They're going to look like, let's grab, I don't know, like this one. Let's say you wanted to copy it and you wanted to paste it and it just looks like trues and falses, which isn't, that's not good, right? That doesn't look like checkboxes. Or if you paste special and you do like a picture, it looks funny. That doesn't look good, right? And it does the same thing in PowerPoint. It's just not very good. So these are really meant to live inside of Excel, okay? Or you can PDF your Excel screen. And then you can share the PDF with your audience that way. What do you think about checkboxes? Good. Thumbs up. Do you want to tell them anything at the end of the video? If I can move the mic closer to you, what do you want to do? All right. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Bye. You did great. What do you think of your first video? Good.